He originally a Mualimu. That is where Ghana tuli sahau. Watia Mualimu na moja.
Sukusaidia raba bani.
This is what Chita about six.
Listen, play. Sinona yen ikifweka hivi
is it recording?
Ukiona imeweka zero vitu vijiti viwili ikiweka arrow ndio is not recording.
Morning class.
Morning, sir.
Morning once again.
Morning, sir.
I'm welcoming you for today's lesson. And what we want to study today is the normal class but in a slight different way. And on the board is what we want to learn today. And I request one of you to read our topic and the subtopic. And Calvin, read for us the topic.
Pressure.
Loud?
Pressure.
Pressure. Share the subtopic.
Pressure.
Atmospheric?
Pressure.
Pressure. Now, the subtopic has two words. We have the word atmospheric and the pressure. The word atmospheric comes from the word atmosphere. Who can assist us to understand what's an atmosphere? An atmosphere. Yes? He's saying an atmosphere is an array of gases. Somebody want something on it? Array of gases. And the word is pressure.
Yes.
The word pressure. Alea.
Yeah.
Thank you for that correction. What's pressure? The term pressure. Below. She's saying that it's force acting on an area. She correct? Yes? She wants to add something on it? Force acting normally?
Perpendicular
per unit area. She correct?
Yes.
Yeah. So they have assisted us to understand what's an atmosphere and pressure. So today we want to look at the effect of that by the activity which we are going to do. On your table, we have worksheet per an activity. We have activity one, so take the worksheet for activity one. You read the instruction carefully and then you start to do. However, in the first activity, some instructions, some procedures have been done for you. For instance, the vaccine has already been applied. And for that to be effective, when you are burning the burning stick, once it has become short, you drop it. While it's burning, that's when you place it away. Now you can start explaining.
You're placing it this way.
No, no, the other way around. When it's light. Okay, put the.
Okay, now you can.
Not only observations.
The letters of them.
Yeah, get the egg gets up to
yeah. This thing goes big, it's like
Those are long splits.
Just one surface.
Okay, now you can wait to the surfaces, the inner, the surfaces that are in contact. Yeah, just wait this part. Just wait it. Yes? Just wait it. Wait it.
Wait to the entire surface, eh? Read the instruction first. What?
They are not there.
Lift it up vertically. Vertically.
Yeah.
Okay, now what is important is for you to hold it like this. And then you lift it up. This is what I want you to observe. That it, you can be able to lift the other glass up. Like this. Can somebody try?
First of all, you can do this, right?
Wow. That is a terminology that is known by the teachers. The topic is on pressure, and the subtopic is atmospheric pressure. Now, probably we could try to review what we have done before, because I know you have done about the pressure in solid, pressure in liquid, and probably I would like to get what you have already learned on liquid pressure. The factors, pressure in liquid. What factors? What does the pressure in liquid depend on? Density of liquid or the fluid? Another? Yes. Yeah, gravitational force. Higher. That one? Yeah. Oh, the depth or the height. Good. So now, we are now going to move further from now the liquid pressure. And we are going now to look at the atmospheric pressure. And we also want to really understand what the atmospheric pressure will do in our body. One, we may ask ourselves, how do we breathe? How do we breathe? For you to take in the air, suppose you hold your ears, your nose. Later on you find that your mouth is open. Why does it happen? So that's us to establish the existence of the atmospheric pressure and the property what it also depends on. And we have a number of activities. There are four in number. One activity, you have the apparatus of the bench, and because you are bending, we require you to form the groups. And to start with, there is one apparatus, one specimen that cannot be used again, and that is where there is air. And there are only the ends. So you form three groups, main groups. Then after that, you split into smaller groups. I was told you around 50.
The second activity, Komora. The glass was upside down and the water was not skinny. Was that that?
Yes.
Why? Yes, is that? Talking about the pressure outside pushing the cardboard upwards. Yes. Somebody with a different opinion? You agree with me? So it means that there's a pressure from out that is pushing. The third activity, that is activity, what was Umi? The observation? The third activity, the observations?
The paper is sticked at the top of the container. The paper, the polythene paper is not coming out of the container. Why? Because.
Be loud.
Be loud.
The paper?
The polythene paper
yeah.
is not coming out of the container.
He's saying that the polythene paper was not coming out whenever it was being pulled. Is that okay? Why? Somebody to assist us? What might be the reason? Dr. Raya?
Yes. I'm saying that when we were trying to put the paper outside, we were creating a vacuum inside the conical flask. And since if we have a vacuum inside the container, it means that the atmospheric, the pressure inside the conical flask was lower than the atmospheric pressure. So the atmospheric pressure keeps pushing that paper downwards as we're pulling it out.
So you're still talking about pressure pushing the paper inside. Somebody with a different an idea. The fourth activity, Lucy.
We pour it in the glass box. It could not lift other, but after waiting it could lift it up.
I've not got your point.
Before eating the glass block, we could not lift them, but after waiting them, we could be able to lift.
He's saying that when the glass blocks were dry, you could easily separate them. But when they were wet, you could not, they stick together. Somebody to assist me understand why. Why was that possible? Yeah?
When you are removing the glass, when you are dry, there was some air between them. But when you get to water,
yeah.
The air was eliminated and occupied by the water which you get there. So when you are trying to remove it, it was hard to separate.
Can you clap for you because it's our last speaker? That when they were there, there was air in between the glass blocks. That air balanced the atmospheric outside. But when you put water, you said you eliminate the air or you remove the air. That's the word used. Now, the atmospheric pressure from outside now dominated because it's not counterbalanced with the one inside. That's why they will stick together. In all of these four activities, we have been mentioning of a certain air from outside, pushing. And when you were telling me what is an atmosphere, you told me it's a layer of air. And where is this? Where is this air? Yeah? On there? Yeah. We stay, let me assume this, of course your girlfriend will not agree, that's the shape of the earth, but I hear that it has some funny shapes. Now, we stay on earth. And above the earth, we have that layer you are talking about on top of it. And we stay on top of the earth. Now this mass of air is a exacting weight on anything that is on top of this earth. Now, you told me that pressure is a result of force and what? Now, this weight is weight force or not?
It is.
Meaning that now this weight of air is out of force. And since it's acting on a surface, there's an area per unit, meaning that it can result to pressure. So that is the one that is acting on this paper, because this paper is on earth and the solid pressure is on top of it. That's what it cannot count. So this activity proves that the atmospheric pressure exists and it has effects. Now, who can tell me an effect in our day-to-day life where you have seen atmospheric pressure working? Well, you have seen that this is working because of this weight of the air. Where? He's saying about the lift pump. Do you know about lift pump?
Yes.
Another typical way of seeing it, yeah? An helicopter. So first it removes the air there. He says that an helicopter is lifted because of atmospheric pressure. The last activity. Yeah? Next time, that's the end of our lesson.